Kathy Wood is the founder, CEO, and chief investment officer at ARK Invest. For better or worse, because there's always two sides to a story, you at ARK Invest have become very closely associated with one stock in particular, and that is Tesla, because you made a lot of waves by attaching a $4,000 price target to the shares at one point.
Yes.
This means that you are obviously very bullish on Tesla and you do hold it in the funds. Is that correct? And if so, is it just a buy and hold, hope it pans out for the next 20 or 25 years? Or is it something different in the way that you approach this particular holding in Tesla?
Hello and welcome back to Tesla News. My name is Marian and I'm your host today, and we will look into all the details why Kathy Wood has made such a genius decision and where Tesla stands today and where it was at that time. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for supporting me. So at that time when Kathy Wood was mentioning $4,000 as a price target, we have seen Tesla struggling a lot while ramping up the Model 3 production and being in production hell, having issues with the financial situation, losing a lot of money, and still Kathy Wood has supported Tesla, has mentioned the 4,000K number, and this was a time when everyone was saying she is crazy. No one could see this entire future. Maybe only you or the small investors out there who always supported Tesla. And remember, Tesla always had a master plan, and this is the reason Kathy Wood was invested into Tesla. And at that time, the 4,000 price target was a crazy target. And remember, pre-split, we are now at $4,300, currently sitting at $860 after the split. So we have reached that goal within two and a half years after this interview on CNBC. So guys, this is just the beginning. And Kathy Wood had price target pre-split of around 10,000 and 15,000, even crazier targets as 25,000 if everything is going right. So guys, always remember that there is so much more upside to Tesla and what could happen in the future when looking at all the things Tesla is working on. And also remember, at that time when the interview was done, there were no Model Ys, there were no Cybertruck reservations, there were no semi-truck reservation, there was no FSD beta version rollout, there were no mega packs being sold and installed everywhere in the world, there was no solar roof production, and there was no huge demand for Powerwalls in this numbers as we see it today. So always remember, we are sitting right now at a situation where the entire Tesla energy demand for Tesla energy products is so much higher than the production Tesla is capable of doing. Furthermore, we see 100,000 Model Y reservations coming in 2 days or even less in China. We do see that we have production ramping up in China, and we could see around 800 to 1 million cars being delivered in 2021. And if you remember where Tesla was at the time of this interview, it is just crazy to see how Tesla has evolved as a car maker, but as well as an energy production company. So always remember, we are just at the beginning, and this interview was really early stage, guys. And we all thought it was not early stage, but if we look into what could happen in the next 2.5 years, this is early stage, guys. We are looking into full production of the Cybertruck in the next 12, 15, 20 months. We are looking into higher production rates for the solar roof, which is quietly already sold and installed every single day, as well as we are looking into the next 4 years with the Biden administration pushing for clean energy, bringing America towards more clean energy. This will profit Tesla as crazy because people will invest money. Investors will go into the Tesla stock and we could see higher prices very soon. I believe we could see higher numbers, higher revenue and all that combined in the next few years. Looking in the background to the Giga Texas Austin, which is currently under construction, it will produce the Tesla Roadster, it will produce the Model Y, it will produce the Tesla Semi, the Cybertruck. This is a massive, massive factory, and we all expect that there might be even more announcements of new Giga or Terra factories, as we call them, in the future. So combining all that, guys, the Tesla energy business might grow even faster, and I'm really sure about that, even faster than the car segment Tesla is working on. We have so many crazy reservation numbers they have to work off till they get to a point where there might be a demand issue, but I don't believe there will be no demand issue in the future. So guys, if you believe in Tesla, you're still early and consider making your own decision, as I'm not a financial advisor, but it's still a really, really good chance to invest into Tesla with all what is ahead in the next few years. And still remember, we are really, really early in the change that is happening to all of us in the way we live, not even taking into consideration all the other projects Elon Musk is working on. If you did enjoy my video, guys, do consider subscribing, and I wish you